When we're using the Smith chart, we're dealing with normalized values. So we need to denormalize the J1.58 off of the Smith chart by dividing by Z0. We're dividing here because we're dealing with an admittance instead of an impedance. So with admittances, we multiply by Z0 to normalize. So I would take a capital Y and I would multiply by Z0 in order to normalize and plot on the Smith chart. And then I would take a little y and divide by z0 in order to denormalize and take a value off of the Smith chart. So here we have y in, we want it equal to y0. Right now it's equal to y at position d, this distance, and we have 1 plus j1.58. We need to divide by z0, which is 70, and we get 1 over 70. I'm not worried about that part right now, so it's j0.023. So that means the true admittance we need to cancel is this j0.023. And the shunt admittance we need from the inductor here, between the two conductors of the transmission line, we need YL is equal to minus J.023. We can rearrange our YL equation for an inductor. It's minus J over omega L. So if I instead move L to the other side and I move YL over here, I'll have L is equal to minus J over omega YL, solving for L, and that's minus J omega 2 pi F. F was given earlier as 300 megahertz, and we can put in minus J0.023. And plugging all this in, hopefully I can squeeze this in, is 23.1 nanohenries. Alright, at this point, after adding the inductor, the input impedance, which was 1 plus J1.58 on the Smith chart, that corresponds to the rest of the transmission line with the load. But when we add the inductor at position D, we're canceling this part, and that gets rid of our imaginary component, and so we're basically getting rid of this imaginary part, and we wind up at the center of the Smith chart, which is where our matched condition is, y0 is equal to 1, normalized y0. But Han likes to keep things simple. Didn't he have space duct tape holding parts of the Millennium Falcon together at one point? Also, Chewbacca doesn't have an inductor of this value lying around, and we don't really want to be bothered with building one. So let's instead see if there are other options available to us, and perhaps an easier option. For example, as shown here, what if we had kept rotating around the Smith chart to the second intersection? So before we stopped here, now we're going to stop at the second intersection with the G equal 1 circle. What would be different if we had chosen this location instead of the top location?